the last vid where we finish up the rear suspension on this thing.
So in this one, it's gonna make a huge transformation. For those of you who don't know, this is our Manco Deuce with a Ninja 250 motor. And right now we're doing all the long travel suspension bits. So with that being said, we have some awesome 22-inch tires for the rear and 20s for up front from Go Power Sports. These are some of the coolest tires we've gotten from them. And then after we get the rear tires on, we're gonna start making up our front suspension with long travel. Basically, we're gonna make like hoops, kind of like a pre-runner truck.
All right, so let's get started with putting the new tires on.
Out with the old, very, very flat.
I think she's still got some life left in her.
Audio.
In with the new, baby. Actually, it works out well because our final rim design is going to be white. Kind of the white army green look, kind of like our first kart Sputnik. So cool, now let's get some shots of this and move on to the front. So the plan for the front suspension is we have the exact same, basically coilover springs to the front. These are actually just spring assisted shocks from a car. We're gonna mount them right up about here and we're gonna build a hoop that comes off this back section here. And with that, we're gonna use our Pro Tools tubing bender actually for like the first time on a project, so that's gonna be really cool. And then after that, we're gonna get to mounting our Go Power Sports rack and pinion piece. All the links for these parts are gonna be in the description. But I guess let's first start by jacking up the front end here and seeing what kind of ride height you want to shoot for.
Find our ride height here.
Does that look about right or a little higher?
Probably right there.
Really?
I don't know, I think a little bit higher.
All right, how's that?
Probably there.
We're looking at the front J-arms and they're really stiff. We kind of been hammering on them and prying on them with the crowbar. They're moving a little bit. We did have the same problem with the Odyssey. So we'll see if we can get them to free up. And if not, then we'll just take them apart and maybe get some rust out.
There, that moved a lot.
There, again.
Oh. See if it like it still doesn't even move.
Still stuck in its first.
Wait, it's gonna get stuck in like an inoperable position. Ready?
Okay.
Oh, yep.
That seemed more free.
It actually really did. That was less force.
Ah. Won't be really good.
Alright, now we're gonna have to hammer it down. Yeah. It's probably an option.
Let's see. Where we move.
Move that out the way.
Yeah, this ain't in the repair manual, but we're desperate now.
All right.
Woo!
Moved a lot.
Yeah, maybe a little more. Got some more.
Oh, almost backed up.
Oh, dang it.
Oh, wait, we have hacks now. We can just keep going around. It's been 2 days, probably a bunch of hours into this, but we finally figured it out. We started to spin it, and that was working, and it was starting to back off a little bit. And then I pulled out the sledgehammer and started hammering on it, and now it's coming out. So we grabbed the camera, so we're crossing our fingers. Hopefully all I have to do is hit this a few times.
Oh. Woo! There we go.
This is nasty. That's all just metal shavings and crap over years. The bushings are actually in really good shape. So I think what we're gonna do is clean out the bushings. They don't even need to come out of here. Sand all the rust off of that, and then we can put it on, and we're gonna have a damn good suspension. Okay, guys, this is what it should be like. Probably even, I don't even know how it was in the factory, but we definitely sanded a lot of material off because we prefer looser. And if it ever rusts a little bit at all, we'll be covered on that base. So we did drill a hole here. So what we're gonna do now is right now we're gonna move on to our suspension. But later, we're gonna slide these off and we're gonna put in a grease fitting there, because I think if there's a healthy amount of grease, that's gonna really prevent some of that rusting that occurred. So now we need to do this all over again with that side. A lot of work has gone down since the last time. We're at this point on both of our J-arms, so that is awesome. And what we did is, because the Manco Deuce has like kind of a different size bolt than like a lot of Go Power Sports stuff, and the hubs are kind of old, bearings worn out and stuff, we went with our Go Power Sports hubs that sit on 5/8 bolts. So all we did was cut the old one off, made sure we had the camber correct and all that. And now we have our new hubs along with our new front Go Power Sports wheels and tires. And we'll get these bolted up on both sides, and we can finally start getting this thing suspension worked out.
I mocked up the springs right now, just as is. It's obviously way too high. We still need to put the hoops up. But the spring rate is actually pretty good. It's more on the stiffer side, but also with our steering, we're not going to be able to have too much flex or it to move that much. But I mean, right here, we have the jack fully extended. Back tires, front tires, all on the ground, so yeah. It's going to be really nice, and also give us some stability not having it too floppy up front.
Yeah, see, so we about have about 4 inches in case we do hit a bump at full compression.
Yeah.
And then you can see we're not even close to being maxed out in the front, and like the back's hardly working. This thing's going to have a stupid amount of flex. So I think what we're going to do now is hit up our Pro Tools bender and bend up some 180s. This is the reason why you upgrade. These things are both dead on, 105 degrees, perfect. And we had the option to actually bend past like 60, which is what we had before. So now what we're gonna do is, these are just gonna fit right up in here. We'll weld them up. We'll just do some quick tacks, and then we can test the suspension and weld it fully up. Yep, we done good. Dang, that's
good.
That's super sick. People.
Yep, let's see it.
Ride tighter. Fresh.
Yeah, that's nice. See, does it compress? Oh, dude. That actually, like, kind of like the back. I mean, less compressive than the back, but like, we have actual front suspension.
Whoa. Here, get up and get back in it.
Yeah.
Let's get an instant replay of that. Okay. Nice.
Yeah, there's our ride height. We got like 6 to probably like 6 or 7 inches of travel.
Yeah, here, let's push it. Can you roll it forward a little bit?
It rolls really nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Like that. Let me try jumping on it. They're very shocky.
Yeah.
But they're not that bad.
That's amazing though, man, because like, we need to get a flex test of this thing.
Yeah,
ASAP.
This thing could probably...
In case you forgot, we got the semi-independent rear. Woo! The tires, I will say, for a buggy this size, the tires are a little on the small side, but big tires just mess with gearing and stuff, especially for small stuff. But really, it's a good look.
Yeah.
I really like
it's
it.
It's pretty even.
Yeah.
Try, get like a shot of jumping in the middle.
Yeah, let's see if,
I won't mess up this seat.
The back definitely moves more. I think our suspension's well balanced.
Yeah.
Dude, the front, I think what happened was, now that there's a larger radius and the shock's upright, it gets a lot more force. Sweet, let's get a flex test. All right, jack is max, so there's still more room to give. But this is our perfect spring setup, guys, because we are stuffing in the front.
and then we have just enough downward flex to where it actually is, the tire is still on the ground. And this is just ignorant back here for go-kart guys.
Before we start on all the steering stuff, we want to have some closure to these hoops here. So what I did is I notched up some support bars just for gusseting, and it's going to look really good. So we're going to have one here and then one right about here. So we'll get these welded in and then we can finish up our steering.
All right, so now that we got our wheel off, the first step is we're gonna cut out the steering shaft and the braces up front and then start putting in our new steering. There you go. There you go. Old steering.
Right now we're bolting up our Go Power Sports rack and pinion. Before we've just used like U-bolts to bolt them in on smaller carts, but because these are 20-inch tires and they're gonna be steering over rocks and stuff, I went ahead and made up these brackets that kind of fit right up in here. There's a lot of hammer marks and stuff on them, but I'm actually pretty proud of this because, I mean, it's hard to bend stuff around curves and this stuff is really tight. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tighten these bolts and then we can go over to the cart and weld them up. Okay, so here's our rack all tacked in. This is going to be more up like this. That looks pretty darn good.
So we got the rack all installed. We changed a little bit of the steering so we get a little bit more angle than stock, but everything's looking really good, so now we're just going to test that when we're moving the suspension up and down and it's flexing, that nothing's binding and the rack has enough like adjustment in it.
So I guess what we're going to look for is if, when we jump on the suspension, if the wheels turn at all. It shouldn't really be an issue because it's a J-arm, but we don't know for sure.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Yeah.
And then do we have wood? My mini stand on this too. Let's see if it fits. I think it's just the boot that's sticking out.
It's kind of touching.
It's really close.
But like, it's still tearing.
Oh yeah, we also got to mount this. Pins.
All right, so yeah, this is what redoing the whole steering looks like. But now what we did was basically moved it forward a little bit so it would eliminate some of our bump steer because it's closer to our pivot point of the J-arm. J-arms are just kind of weird because it like moves like this and your steering's here. But we got the best we could and it actually doesn't have very much bump steer at all. I'm gonna bounce on it. And then also if you look here, our driver's side hit at full flex before and now there's probably still an inch of room at full flex. So we're not gonna have any issues there. But you can see our wheels are still staying relatively straight.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what we're gonna do now is we'll take this all apart, weld it up finally, because it's all good now, and then that's gonna wrap up our front suspension and steering bit. Okay, a ton of work went into this video. This was definitely one of the more complicated things we had to do to the Deuce. But we have our super awesome rack and pinion steering. It's not too heavy or anything. It's not gonna bump out of our hands when we hit ruts and stuff. Our suspension looks awesome with our hoops and stuff and our spring assisted shocks. So thank you guys for watching. Thank you Go Power Sports. All the parts from the steering assembly is from Go Power Sports. And be sure to stay tuned because we're working on getting the Ninja engine running in this thing and it's going to be an absolute blast. We can really see it coming together now that all the suspension is done. So thank you guys for watching. See you next time.